One.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the session of Wildlife Week. Our topic for today is super serpents, and I am super excited for the same because I personally like snakes a lot. So basically, our president has not been able to join us today because she had an emergency surgery to perform. So she has not been able to join today. So I will be introducing IVSA to you. So IVSA stands for International Veterinary Students Association. And IVSA Mumbai is a local chapter of IVSA Global. And we're basically an organization of veterinary students all over the globe. And we work, exchange ideas, and bring about, you know, awareness about various topics related to veterinary. So I am Ruchi Latkar from second year, and that is Atharva Malavade from fourth year. So Atharva, can you carry on?
Yeah. So introducing our speaker for today, Chaitanya Risbud is a naturalist and trekker by profession for the past 7 years. He's working with InSearch Outdoors, a nature education and travel company. He's specially interested in snakes and amphibians, along with many other members of nature. He is educating students and adults on nature for the past many years. He also actively participates in wildlife research programs conducted by InHealth. So, sir, could you start with your talk?
Yes. Thank you, Atharva and Ruchi.
I'll share my screen and we'll be in the background if you need us.
Yes. Okay, so today's lecture is on super serpents. That's why I put the famous Pokemon called Ekans in the first slide. And my Atharva had introduced me just now. And we are going to begin with the first slide, and Mr. Ekans is going to take us in the whole snake world. Okay, so next slide, Ruchi. So what is a snake? Many times people ask me that, are snakes are you know, slimy or what? Snakes are not at all slimy, or snake is not a death. What is snake is, snakes are elongated, legless, carnivorous reptiles. So reptiles have all, like all other squamates, snakes are ectothermic vertebrates covered with overlapping scales. The scales snakes have is made up of protein called keratin, which is our nails and hair are made up of keratin. So with the same protein, the scales are made up of keratin protein. So all snakes are purely carnivorous, and squamates is the reptiles which have scales. Okay. And ectothermic, we will come to that point in next slide. Okay, next slide, Ruchi. So where can we find snakes? Snakes can be found in all over the world except for Antarctic and Arctic regions. Snakes can be found in, you know, say Ladakh, and even in deserts, in tropical evergreen forest, in say grasslands, in and even in cities. You never know, some snake is slithering in your neighborhood right now. There are approximately 300 species of snakes are found in India mainly. I'm saying nearly because every year new species is discovered, and you never know, one species or other species may get also extinct. Last month, My colleague discovered a new snake species from Arunachal Pradesh Pokhre Tiger Reserve called Salazar Spit Viper. It is named after the famous Harry Potter character Salazar Slytherin. So there are nearly 300 species of snakes are found in India, and only four of them, the species, are fatal to human beings. So other snakes are either non-venomous or not fatal to human beings. Okay, next. Evolution of snakes. Snakes are evolved from lizards. Okay, this is the first fossil of snake, and this is dated back to 112 million years old. That is in Cretaceous era. In that era, the reptiles dominated the earth. Just like now, the mammals have dominated the earth in say land, in water, and in air. At that time, reptiles have dominated the earth. Just like the West Indies team dominated the world cricket in 70s and 80s decade, the reptiles dominated the whole earth in Cretaceous period. Okay, so some lizard-like animals were found in sea that came to land and they started living underground. So when you are underground, you don't need your legs to move. So they just started sleeping. And in course of time, gradually they lost their legs. And what found is today's snake. Okay, next please. The snakes in Hindu literature and popular culture. We can find snakes in various cultures and in various traditions. In first picture here is Vasuki Nag, which is wrapped around Lord Shiva's neck. So Vasuki Nag story is that snake is used in Samudra Mantham. And Samudra Mantham story, I guess everyone knows. And the next one is Sheshanag. Sheshanag is the king of serpents. And it is believed that all planets are residing on Sheshanag's hood. And Lord Vishnu resides on Sheshanag. Okay. The next is Manasa. The Manasa Nag is goddess of curing snake bites and sister of Vasuki Nag. Okay. And this picture, I guess everyone knows what it is. It is from the famous Harry Potter movie called Chamber of Secrets, and this is the basilisk which Harry Potter killed. The next one is Anaconda and Hyena. These two pictures spread many myths about snakes, that snake eats human being or snake can take the revenge, which is not at all. Next, please. Okay, so we'll see the classification of snake, and we'll see the classification of cobra. So the kingdom is Animalia. Many times what happens is, if you want to know an animal very nicely, so you have to check the classification or taxonomy of that animal. But sometimes what happens is, when we hear classification and taxonomic heavy words, we get bored. Yeah. So to simplify that, we'll consider as this kingdom is a big school of animals. Okay, so this school's name is Kingdom Animalia. Okay, and just like school has many standards, many classes, many many divisions, just like this school also has classes and divisions. Can we go to that slide? Okay, so the cobra is in phylum Chordata. The Chordata means those animals who have notal cord running from their head to their tail. It means spinal cord. Those animals who has this spinal cord, they are classified in phylum Chordata. The next one is class Reptilia. Okay. All the reptiles are classified in this class. It's just like we have 10th class or 9th class. All reptiles are classified in this Reptilia class. The next one is division. So division order is Squamata. Okay, those who have scales on their body are classified in this order, Squamata. And just like in school, the divisions have families of students. Just like in this Animalia school, they have many families studying in this class. Okay, so cobra is in Elapidae family. The snakes in Elapidae family has short and hollow fangs, which are venom fangs. Okay, and the genus and species is Naja Naja. The word written here is tautonym. It is a characteristic of taxonomy. In this taxonomical feature, the genus and species name are same. Okay, so the animals which have genus and species names same, they are called as tautonym. We have one here, Naja Naja, and everyone knows Chital, right? Chital's scientific name is Axis Axis. Or we can find a fish in Brahmaputra River called Rama Rama. Okay, can we go to next slide?
Sir, they're still saying that the voice is not clear. So, okay. Could you probably turn off your video so we can save some bandwidth?
Stop. Can I say stop? Can?
Yeah. Chaitanya, sir?
Yes.
Yeah, please continue.
Yeah, from the same slide.
Keep your video off. Your audio will be on. Can you see the slide?
No.
Yeah, better, sir. I'll full screen the slide now.
Yeah, is it okay? Okay, so now on this slide, we will see the characteristic comparison of snake with mammal and bird. Okay, so mammals, all mammals have hair or fur on their skin. All birds have feathers, but all snakes have scales on their body. Okay, the next one is presence of sweat glands and mammary glands. Birds have presence of oil glands, and there is no such external gland present on a snake's body. We'll explain this. And this slide will come in handy when we go to the myths about snakes on that slide. All mammals and birds are endothermic. That means they have their own temperature regulating system. But snakes are endothermic. Snakes and other reptiles are endothermic. That means they don't have their own temperature regulatory system. And they are cold-blooded animals. They require heat to resume their bodily functions. So what they do is, in morning time, they go and sit under the sunlight. Okay, and as the heat increases, they go to in their burrow or their say hunting or anything they want to do. Okay, other thing is all mammals are carnivorous and herbivorous both. Okay, majority of birds are carnivorous. Because 70% birds eat insects, and all snakes are only carnivorous. No snake can drink milk, or no snake can say that today is Shiva Jayanti, or I have upas, I don't eat rat, or etc. like that. Okay, so next slide. Now we'll see anatomy of a snake. Imagine you have to fit every organ in a linear manner. Okay, so now we'll start from the head. The tongue of snake is forked tongue. Okay, you can see the two parts of tongue here, and after that there is a tongue opening called glottis over here. Okay, this glottis helps snake breathing while the snake is swallowing its prey. Okay, when the prey is swallowed, it goes to esophagus and that leads to stomach, and that prey is digested over here. The next one is trachea, and trachea is attached to lung. There are two lungs in snakes, but most probably only one lung is functioning. You can see the one lung is very elongated and it is reaching till the body's end. Okay. These are venomous fangs, and it is attached with the venomous gland over here. The venom comes this one. The Jacobson's organ, will explain it in later. These are the venom fangs. The lapidi, the fangs are fixed and they are not long. But in vipers, the fangs are long and they have hinge joint. So when a snake closes its mouth, the fangs are folded, and when snakes opens its mouth to bite, the fangs come out and snake bites its prey, and the teeth are covered in a sheath. That sheath goes backwards and that puts the pressure on venom gland, and the venom is released through the teeth. Okay, the teeth serve as injection syringe the injection. Okay, here it is skeleton of a snake. The notochord, that means the spinal cord which runs from neck till the tail, so it is called as chordata. Okay, next slide please. Molting. In mammals we have sweat glands, and with the help of sweat glands our skin gets clean, but in snakes and other reptiles it is not possible because they don't have the sweat glands. So what they do is they molt. Okay, in snakes the entire dead skin layer is removed once and for all, but in some reptiles the skin is shedded in parts by parts. Okay, molting we can see also in arthropods because they have the chitinous layer on their body and that prevents their growth, but in snakes they have scales on their body, and it is very important that they molt every after every say period. Okay, snakes molt in once in 3 months. Okay, what happens is the snakes have a transparent scale on their eye, so when the dead skin layer starts to form, the eye looks say bluish, and after some days the whole body looks like whitish in color. So the snake stops eating in that period. Okay, so when the time comes to shed the skin, a moist layer is formed under between the body and the skin. Okay, so at that time what snake does is it rubs its head on a rough surface and goes through a cavity, so the skin comes just like we remove our skin, it is inside out. Okay, and the molting serves in very various manners. It removes all the ticks and mites from the body and it cleans the snake's body. Okay, and when the snake baby is in egg, it has a egg tooth on their tip of the mouth, so when snakes want to get out of the egg, they use that egg tooth and comes out of the egg, and after 24 hours it molts first time, and in that molting that egg tooth goes off and a cavity remains there, and without opening its mouth the snake can easily can flick his tongue. Okay, next slide please. So the snack time, what snakes eat, we'll see. Next slide please. snakes eat a lot of various things. Okay, so there is a king cobra eating a rat snake. Snake is eating another snake because it has to control the number of other snakes. Okay, and in this picture, a python is eating crocodile. Okay, and in this picture, a checkered keelback snake is eating a frog. This frog is just like Atharva said. This frog is the new species that Inher has described from the Sasvad area, and it is Perothica paschima. When I was with went to fieldwork, we saw this thing happening. Next slide, please. But sometimes, take one slide back. But sometimes there is also very interesting things happen in nature. So, just like here, the bullfrog is eating the snake. Okay. Sometimes the predator can be also a prey. Okay. Next slide, please. Now we'll move to sensory organs. Next slide. The snake has sensory organs like eyes, heat sensing pits, Jacobson's organ, scales. The snake's eyesight is very weak. They can only see light or there is darkness, and they can only detect moving objects. Okay. So to counter this, they have very strong sense of smell. Okay. And some pituapers, in some pituapers, there are heat sensing pits situated between the nose and their eye, just like here. It is a bamboo pituiper, and these are the heat sensing pits. In some in pythons also, we can see the heat sensing pits, and they are very sensible. They can sense the difference in temperature of 0.001 degree. Okay. And this helps the snake in to hunt in even in darkness. And what snakes eat is frog. Frogs are also cold-blooded animals. So what they do is they just see through these heat sensing pits. And what they can see is if there is heat in front of them, they can see the redness in there in that. So I have experienced it very nicely when our herpetology batch was there. We took all the students to Kamshed for field visit, and it was raining like cats and dogs, and we found almost 3 foot long bamboo pituiper, and my colleague took it off from the bush, and it was not sitting on the ground properly. So what I did is took my cap off and rubbed it on my pant. The cap was wet and the pant was also wet, but how much heat can it produce? But when I showed that cap to the snake, it came into this striking position. These heat sensing pits are that much strong. Okay. Another is Jacobson's organ. In this picture, you can see snake is flickering his tongue. Snakes smell through their tongues, and what they do is they collect the smell particles from the air, took it back, and they touch it to this organ called Jacobson's organ. The Jacobson is a scientist name which has given to this organ in the respect of that scientist. And that organ is connected to snake's brain. So the analysis is done. What smell it is? It is of water, or it is a prey, or it is any danger. Another one is scales. The scales have covered entire body of a snake, and they have many names according to their position. Say lorial scale, labial scale. This is the body of common crate, and you can identify the common crate by its hexagonal scales on this body. Okay, the scales protect the snake from outside dangers. Okay, and snakes cannot hear, so what they do is they sense the animal or which is whatever it coming towards them by the vibrations. Okay. Next slide, please. So how snakes move, we'll come to how snakes move. There are four types of snake movements. First one is concertina. In this movement, what snake does is they coil half part of their body and move forward. And just like in this manner, the snake moves forwards. Okay. The next one is serpentine movement. All I must have seen the how cobra moves, just like serpentine movement in S shape. Okay. The another one is side widening. In this movement, snake only touches its 3 points on that ground. Body's 3 point on that ground, and it goes like side widening manner. If anyone has seen saw scale viper moves in side widening manner, and maximum snakes move in serpentine manner. Okay. The another one is caterpillar. In this movement, all the heavy snakes like python and Russell's viper use this caterpillar movement of locomotion. In this movement, the snake puts every rib of his body forward. Okay, so the snake moves in one line. Okay, next slide, please. Now we'll come to snake venom. In India, there are four major venomous snakes, which are cobra, crate, Russell's viper, and saw-scaled viper. Okay, the snake venom is highly modified saliva containing zootoxins. Now, what is zootoxin? Zootoxins are anything toxic substance produced by an animal. It can be any animal, say snake or scorpion, that facilitate immobilization and digestion of prey. So, snake venom contains cocktail of protein and enzymes. Okay, when snake bites, it injects its venom in its prey's body, and the enzymes start to digest the prey outside snake's body, so that snake has to put minimum energy to digest the prey. Okay, but snake does not deliver full amount of his venom into the body of his prey, because the snake requires too much energy to reproduce the venom. Okay. Now here you can see the sheath of skin that protects the fang, and here it is the venom drop. And this picture is effect of snake venom on human body. This is a saw-scaled viper bite. And some species are also able to spit their venom. So in Africa, there is one cobra called spitting cobra. So it spits its venom in their prey's or any human's eyes. Okay. Next, please. Yeah. So this is determining venom toxicity, LD50. This factor requires is lethal dose. And it is defined as the dose required to kill half the members of tested population after specified test duration. Okay. Next slide, please. Now we'll come to types of venom. There are two types of venom in snakes. One is neurotoxic venom and another is hemotoxic venom. Neurotoxic venom attacks on nervous system. There are gaps in our nerve system, they are called synapses. And what this venom does is it blocks all the signals. This type of venom is found in cobra and crate. Okay. So the bite symptoms are as swelling and redness around wound, pain at bite site, difficulty in breathing. Okay. What hemotoxic venom does is attacks on vascular system. That means when the viper bites us, the RBCs get clogged, okay, and rupturing of veins. So their prey dies because of internal bleeding. Okay, bite symptoms are pain at bite site and massive swelling, massive pain occurs. And examples are saw-scaled viper, Russell viper, and other vipers like bamboo pit viper and Malabar pit viper. Next slide, please. This is very interesting point. difference between venom and poison. Many times we observe that people say snakes are poisonous. No single snake is poisonous. Snakes are always venomous. There is big difference between venom and poison. Venom actually attacks when the effects of venom is observed, that when it enters in our bloodstream. But poison is different. We can observe the effects of poison if we digest, if we eat or drink or say inhale or touch. Okay, we get food poisoning, not get food venom. So there are massive difference between venom and poison. All snakes are venomous. No snake is poisonous. Okay, next slide, please. So we'll move to anti-snake venom and how it is produced. To cure snake bite, the snake venom is used. Okay, so what they do is they inject some amount of snake venom in horse's body. Okay, and the dose is increased day by day. And when it comes to after some days, the horse's WBCs, say white blood cells, develop antibodies against that venom. And at this time, the plasma of that blood is separated, and this anti-snake venom is produced. So in anti-snake venom, there are two types, say polyvalent and monovalent. In polyvalent anti-snake venom, two or three species of venom are mixed and they are injected in horse's body. So in India, polyvalent anti-snake venom is produced. What they do is they mix Soskett viper, Russell viper, cobra and Krebs venom, and with use of that, they produce anti-snake venom. In India, there are some institutes that produce anti-snake venom, like Serum and Hafkin. And in other countries, there are monovalent anti-snake venoms. So monovalent is only that snake's venom is used to produce anti-snake venom. There are some interesting facts related to anti-snake venom. Albert Calmet is the first researcher to develop anti-snake venom in late 1890s. He was a French researcher. And if you search on YouTube, Venom Man, Tim Freedy, he's a man who has developed antibodies against snake venom. So what he did is he injected a small amount of snake venom in his body for many years. And today he has developed immunity against that snake venom. You can search on YouTube, say just put Venom Man Team Freddy and you will get the video. And this process is called a snake milking. Okay, so what they do is they catch a snake and plastic cloth on a beaker and the bites on that beaker. This is called a snake milking. So in 1960, National Institute of Health told Bill Hast. Bill Hast was a scientist to collect half liter of venom of coral snake. It took 69,000 milkings over 3 years period. So imagine what quantity, how much little quantity we get after one milking. Okay. Next slide, please. These are the shocking results I got when I was searching about snake venom on Google. And even on internet, it is said that 10 most poisonous snakes in the world and poisonous most dangerous. It is not at all true. Okay. Next slide, please. Yeah, the myths about snakes, very interesting thing. The first and the biggest myth in India is snake drink milk. Snake does not drink milk. The milk is not snake's natural food. If snake drinks accidentally, then it can die because of diarrhea. So in India, what happened earlier is at the time of Nag Panchami, 2 or 3 days before, the Garudis went in the field and they catch a snake. And after catching, they remove all the teeth of the snake and they sew their mouth with needle. And after 2-3 days, so after sewed mouth, the snake cannot eat anything or drink anything. And after the 2-3 days, when it sees some liquid part, it naturally dips its mouth in that liquid. And what people think is it is drinking milk. No, it is not drinking milk at all. Snakes can take revenge. Snakes have very little brain. So what they can remember is only their food and only their area. They cannot remember anything like Chaitya caught me and that's I will bite him today. This does not happen. Okay. The Nagmani. Many people believe that there is a Nagmani on cobra's head, which is not at all true. And if you get that Nagmani, you will be a millionaire and all that. It is false. Snakes have hair. Okay. In earlier slide, molting slide, what we saw is the snake moves through a cavity. But sometimes what happens is some part of the molt remains on the body of snake. But some people say is the snake have hair, and some people also stick hair on the snake's head and they say it as the snake has hair. Wine snake can break skull. If anyone has seen wine snake, it has pointed mouth, but that pointed thing is very soft. It can break human skull. Wine snake pushes at height of say 5 or 6 feet. Going in the jungle, what the snake did is snake can fly.
Chaitanya, sir, are you there?
Yes, yes, I'm there.
Yeah, please continue.
Okay. Snake cannot fly. There are gliding snakes in India. So what that snake does is it throws his body to another tree, to reach to another tree. Dance on tune of charmer. Many times we have seen that the charmer moves its, make the cobra dance. But that cobra cannot hear it properly and it only detects the movement of that charmer. Okay. Snake can hypnotize. As we seen earlier, the snake don't have eyelids. So their eyes are open all the time. And what people believe is the snake can look into your eye and it can say hypnotize you. Another thing is, pregnant woman sees in the eye of snake, the baby flicks his tongue like a snake. Imagine what limits the baby has to transform if he has to flick the tongue like this. It has to develop fork tongue and develop Jacobson's organ. It is not at all true. If venomous snake bites in water, the venom doesn't show this effect. This is also a false thing. If snake wants to chase a man, he grabs his tail in his mouth. First thing, snake don't want to chase a man and they don't do like this. Okay, they are not able to do like this. And rat snake drinks milk by strangling leg of cow or buffalo. As we have seen earlier, milk is not natural food of snake and so as a human being. So snake doesn't drink milk or doesn't eat man. Okay, next slide, please. So this is the last slide, and I have one very interesting video of what effects of snake venom on human blood. Okay. Ruchi, can you play that video?
Just a minute.
The RBCs or all are got clotting.
Right. So, do you have anything else to share, sir?
No, no, I'm done.
Okay. So, I think we'll take some question answers. You can turn on your camera now, sir. This is our first question. What is the difference between cobra and the snake?
There is no difference in cobra and snake. Cobra itself is a snake. And the U mark in that picture is, it is a pattern on the cobra's hood, which is relatable to 10, number 10 in Modi language.
Okay. Lots of comments for voice glitching.
Molting occurs once in 3 months or 3 or 4 months of period.
Does climate affect molting?
No, not at all.
Please throw some light on parthenogenesis and snakes.
Parthenogenesis. Only female snake or male. Parthenogenesis means only one type of sex is born. Okay. Only female or male snakes are born and they lay eggs and I don't have much idea on this. I will get back to you.
Makran sir has answered this. He has added that in India, parthenogenesis snakes is found in species belonging to Indo-Hylops, commonly known as flying snakes. Our next question is, why do the snakes inject venom? Is it so that the prey can be immobilized?
Yeah, to immobilize the prey, the snake uses its venom to immobilize or to digest outside the body or in self-defense, the snake uses its venom.
Which book shall be preferred for learning snake evolution?
I'll have to check it on Google. Sorry, I don't have any idea.
Parul asks milking.
Milking means extraction of venom from snake.
Srishti Bhave has something to add. that very recently few snakes have been found in Amazon to be poisonous, and a snake in India, the checkered keelback, to possess some amount of poison like chemical on its body. Thank you, Srishti. Parul asks, which crystal? I think when it's in relation to Nagmani or something.
Yeah. It is not at all true about Nagmani.
Since Jacobson's organ helps in sensing smells of prey, water, etc., so do snake tongues have taste buds?
No, there are no taste buds on snake's tongue. Just okay. Receives the smell particles and collects it.
Indraneel asks, are there institutes around Mumbai that teach snake handling?
You can learn from Forest Department if you want to learn the snake handling.
Arjun asks, illegal smuggling of red sand is still being done in India, leading them on the verge of extinction. What is your take on it?
You have to put a ban on all snakes come in 1972 Wildlife Protection Act in Schedule 1, and it is illegal to smuggle, and there is ban on snake smuggling.
Okay. Srishti asks, have there been any studies on lifespan of a snake?
It is very tough to study the lifespan of snake because they live most of their life in underground. There may be some studies going on. I'll have to check.
What should we do to keep snakes away? What are precautions we should take when we see a snake?
First thing when we see snake, we have to do is not to get panicked and let the snake go its way and we go to our way. And put light on every street or every, say, and wear shoes, use torch. These methods can be used to put the snakes away. And in urban or rural areas, the people should sleep above the ground. Many a time, bite has happened when people are sleeping in their.
Yes, sir.
Meghna asks, I read somewhere that even non-venomous snakes contain traces of venom in their saliva and a huge dose can be lethal. Is this true?
There are no traces of venom, but they can contain some bacteria or viruses in their saliva, and that can affect this.
NatureWeb asks, like humans, does snake fall sick? Like humans, does the snake fall sick?
Yeah, there are some diseases in snakes also, like mouth rot, and there some kind of digestive system diseases in snake. Like a ringworm or something like that.
Srishti asks,
snakes should be rescued when it is in your neighborhood or in your house or in your factory and it causes some danger. Then snakes should be rescued.
Ayush asks, what should be done if cobra or other types of vipers are bitten? First aid. What is
when a snake bites us, we have to do is move to government hospital. Because in government hospital, the doctors have experience to handle the snake bite cases. Doctor now says do not tie the tourniquet because it clots venom in that limited part of body and that can cause gangrene. So
I would like to add this question. In many movies and shows, we see that if a snake has bitten, then the actor just sucks out the blood from that area and spits. Is that really, does it really work? And can that also prove
that
dangerous?
That cannot work because a very little amount of venom is injected in our body. And the venom gets mixed in our blood very easily. So we cannot suck that blood out and spit it out. There is also a myth with snakes that if we apologize to snake, the snake takes its venom back. It is totally laughable.
Okay. To Kanchan's question, Makrant sir has answered that Snakes of India by Romulus Whittaker and Ashok Captain is a good book to learn. So thank you, sir.
So Nikunj asks, what are the safety measures to be taken immediately after being bitten by a venomous snake?
Safety measure number one is to calm the patient down. Because if the blood pressure increases, the heart heart pumps the blood very rapidly in our body and that can spread the venom very fast. So you have to calm the patient out and keep the bitten part below the level of heart. Okay, and take that person immediately to government hospital. And to calm the patient, do not give him alcohol.
Are there any snakes which look identical and can be confused for layman to differentiate between venomous and non-venomous?
Yeah, there are some species which look identical, like common crate and wool snake. Okay, the difference in these snakes is their stripes on their body. Okay, so in wool snake, the stripes on their neck is darker and it gets faint in when we move to tail, okay, and completely opposite in crate. There are no or very faint stripes on the neck of crate's body and it gets darker when we move to tail. So this is the one big difference between common crate and wool snake. Common crate is highly venomous snake and wool snake is non-venomous snake.
Nikhil asks, why should we not kill snakes?
Because snakes eat the rodents and helps us in controlling the rodent number. And rodents destroy large amount of grains and food in our country.
Yes.
Vishal asks, do Russells have different chain patterns? Can we use that to identify them?
Yes, there is a chain pattern on the Russell's viper and we can use it as identification key. And another key to identify viper is the triangular head. They have perfectly triangular head. All vipers have perfectly triangular head.
Vaishali asks, many countries allow snakes to be kept as pets. What kind of threat does this possess? And can snakes really be domesticated?
No, snakes cannot be domesticated. And in India, all the snakes are protected under Wildlife Protection Act. So we cannot keep snakes as pets in our country.
Yeah, that is another point to add. Thanks, Swayam. Rashi asks, toxicity level of venom determine quantity of anti-venom required after bite, or is it the same for any snake bite? That is a very good question.
That depends on how much envenomation we have got. Okay. So in some cases, only 5 vials of anti-snake venom are enough. But in some cases, even after giving 15 to 20 vials, the patient dies. That depends on how much venom has entered our body and how much time it took to take to the hospital.
So Parul asks, if the snake is highly venomous, then how we can protect ourselves if we are alone on our adventure?
So first thing we can do is you have to learn to identify the difference between venomous and non-venomous snake. And when you do, when you are able to do that, you can perfectly protect yourself from those snakes. And first thing you have to do is stand still. If you are standing still, the snake cannot detect your movement and think as you are as your threat. And it will go his way and we can go to our way.
Nikhil asks, we've seen a lot of snake videos where they just vomit when caught. Why does that happen? Referring to the video of cobra vomiting its out.
This thing is of self-defense. They have to reduce their body weight so that it can help them in running faster. So if the snake has eaten recently and we handle the snake, that snake regurgitates whatever he has eaten. This happened with me when I done a checkered killback call in on Siyogat Road. There are people standing with sticks and all, and they were saying that whenever it comes out, we are going to kill it. So I have to took him in a gunny bag, and when I checked the gunny bag after some time, it has regurgitated the frog which he had eaten. And it can sometimes hurts the can also hurt the snake, that regurgitating thing.
Yes. So Parul asks, is there any homemade remedy if the snake is highly venomous? Shortest death in few seconds, then what we can do?
No, there is no home remedy. Only remedy is anti-snake venom.
Nature Web asks, once I saw in the news channel, they were showing a white snake and they were referring to it as albino snake. I could not understand the meaning. Can you tell what does albino snake mean?
Albinism is lack of melanin. So the melanin is the color pigment that gives colors to animals. Okay. So when there is lack of melanin, it can be albino snake.
So Prajyot asks, what makes snakes come in houses and rural areas and how it can be prevented?
We have food wastage from in our houses. So we throw it on the open area. Okay. And to eat that wastage, the rats and mice come. And to eat rats and mice, the snake comes. Okay. If we throw that wastage properly, the rat won't come and the snake will not come.
To the question about whether we can have the amount of vials required, Makran sir has answered that the number of anti-venin vials required to cure a victim depends on multiple factors such as age, gender, immunity, previous experience, time to reach the hospital, doctor's experience, and so on. So thank you for that, sir. Again, Nikhil asks, are all snakes covered under Schedule 1?
Yes, all snakes are covered under Schedule 1.
Swayam asks, albino snakes are... Oh no, he's answering the question. Albino snakes are snakes which lack in coloration pigment, and also they have red color to their eyes.
I just want to add to this that they don't have red color in their eyes, but because the melanin in the eye is also less, the inside of the eye gets reflected, and that's why it's appears to be red, but the iris is not red in color. Prajot Khedkar asks, how to distinguish between venomous and non-venomous snakes?
There are identification keys to identify all the big four members of venomous snakes. The cobra has its hood, the biggest key, identification key. And all vipers have their triangular heads. Okay, if you see triangular head snake, you have to be at safe distance. And identification of crate is a bit tricky. As I said earlier, they have the stripe mark on their body. So if you read and study a little bit, you can identify between venomous and non-venomous.
Srishti asks, can we identify male and females in snakes?
Externally, we cannot identify male and female in snakes. To identify this, we have to press the anal scale against it, the snake's body. If the hemipenis comes out, then the snake is male. And if it doesn't, then snake is female. Generally, in snakes, females are longer than males.
Vaishali asks, many posts have been circulating which say that the marks or the fangs leave can determine whether the snake was venomous or not. Can we really use fang marks to determine that?
No. In case of crate bite, there are no bite marks. So we cannot rely on bite marks to determine the venomous or non-venomous.
Nikhil asks, what are mildly venomous snakes?
Mildly venomous snakes are those snakes that have venom, but it cannot affect on your human body. Or they have their venom fangs behind their mouth. Okay, so the fangs do not reach our body part. And even if they bite, the effect are not much.
Arjun asks, apart from the four big four and the king cobra, which other snakes are fatal to adult humans? Are Malabar and bamboo pit vipers as much dangerous as they are said to be?
They cannot cause death, but there is a lot of pain when Malabar or bamboo pit viper bite. So they are not fatal, but the pain is unbearable.
Can we identify the snake with its skin?
With its skin?
Scale.
I guess he wants to ask that the pattern. Yes, we can identify the snake with it from its skin pattern or scale pattern.
Nikhil says, asks, I have heard you can tell male and female in snakes from the tail length to body length ratio. Is it true?
I have no idea about this. This factor is called as dry bite. So the snake requires huge amount of energy to produce venom. But sometimes what snake does is it doesn't inject venom in its prey or in defense mechanism. It is called as dry bite. Very little venom is injected or no venom is injected in this case.
Vaishali asks, does the temperature of incubation of eggs determine their sex?
Yes. More temperature gets males, or less temperature of incubation comes females or it is vice versa. I'm a bit confusing in this.
Prajot asks, is cannibalism in snakes common?
We cannot say it is cannibalism, but the king cobra eats other snakes. And only king cobra and sometimes common crate eats other snakes. So it is not very common.
Correct. Thanks, Kanchan. We'll just wait for a couple of minutes. If there are any more questions, we'll take them. I think we have answered all questions that have popped up in the chat window. One last question. Do two-headed snakes occur commonly?
No, it is a phenomenon called polycephaly, and it is not very common. And those snakes cannot survive very much long. King cobra can go to 12 or 15 feet, maximum 16 feet. This is the longest venomous snake in the world.
Makran sir adds that yes, cannibalism is not common, but it has been observed many times when snake is eating another snake of the same species. Thank you. Priyanka asks, at times snakes feel that we are trying to harm them. Anything we can do to ensure snakes that we are trying to help them?
Sometimes what occurs is the snake gets cornered. And when the snake is cornered, it gets angry and starts hissing noises or take the hold. If you don't corner the snake and let the snake go in its own way, the snake cannot harm us.
Do mother snakes eat their children?
No, there is no parental care assisting in snakes. When the female lays its eggs, it leaves the eggs on their own. But in king cobra, the king cobra female builds a nest, lays eggs in it, and when the snake, young snake come out, the female leaves the nest.
Swayam asks, how do venomous snakes kill their prey?
They either strangulate them or bite them till the prey is dead.
Do all snakes lay eggs?
No, all snakes do not lay eggs. There are some species who give birth to young ones, like Russell's wife.
Nikhil sir asks, are spitting cobras found in India?
No.
Where are they found, sir?
In Africa.
I find water snakes very peculiar. Can you tell me something about them?
There are some species of water snakes found in India, like checkered keelback and dog-faced water snake. They live most of their life in underwater. And they eat fish and frogs, etc. And mainly they are non-venomous.
We have a couple of more questions coming up. We'll just wait for them to load. Makran sir adds, there are many species in which females stay with the eggs till they hatch, for example, pythons. Thank you again for that. I think that's it. Should we wait for more questions?
No, it's all.
So, I would like to take this opportunity to thank you for joining us today. And also, I would apologize that our president could not join us. She had an emergency to attend to. And I personally love snakes a lot, so I found this session to be very interesting. And I'm sure our viewers also enjoyed the session, found it to be very informative. So thanks to you, and thanks to all the viewers who joined us today in this session. Atharva, anything you want to say?
Yeah, it was just a wonderful session, and I've been growing up watching all these snakes and getting into this detail. It was really informative. I did not know a lot of things about them. Thank you so much.
Question coming up. I think, guys, after this, I'm not taking any more questions. BL Kulkarni asks, are black mambas more venomous than green mambas?
Yes, can be. Black mamba is more venomous than green mamba.
And do some species of venomous snakes have different potency of venom?
Yes,
it's just these questions are interesting, so I can't not answer them.
Common crate has more potency than cobra, and Brussels viper also has great potency to kill a man. And that also depends on when the snake has eaten. If the snake had eaten recently, the potency of venom is more. And if the snake is hungry, the potency of venom is less. Yeah.
So the president is not going to be able to join. Final note. Thank you to everybody. And thank you especially to Chaitanya sir for sharing his knowledge. And a lot of comments are coming up thanking you for the session, saying that it was a wonderful session. Let's end the now.